scenery while I do my makeup because I ran out of card storage on this memory card and I had to delete stuff and I didn't want to just like sit in the bathroom and do that because other people need to use the bathroom. So, outfit, we're gonna make her look better, I promise. Not just like some middle schooler that just threw something on or anywhere besides somewhere. Today's gonna be a very fun vlog. I'm very excited for this. I don't really know what to expect because I've never done this before. But I'm going to a very exciting event in Brooklyn today. I'm going to the grand opening of the new Glossier store. As you guys know, Glossier is like one of my favorite brands. Like literally, like when I do my makeup, like you can see like half of the products I use. Like my products are literally either MAC or Glossier. Like those are my two favorites. So I'm so excited because I've really missed like them having a store. Like they literally haven't had a store since like ever. I literally remember like being 14, like forcing my mom to go because I'd seen it online. It was really cool and I like started using their products and it's really cool to like now like be able to like see their new store. And I was so jealous after the pandemic because like I felt like other places were getting stores and I'm just like, well, what about New York? Like this is like your home base. I don't know if there's gonna be like a big ass line outside and that's what's like kind of scaring me. So I'm getting there kind of early. I'm gonna get Diet Coke on my way just because I want Diet Coke. But yeah, so it's like 8:30 right now. I'm gonna do my makeup and straighten my hair and then leave. So I went to a concert a couple days ago. I saw Maud Latour. If you guys don't know who she is literally amazing. She was on the Do Revenge soundtrack. She sang the Kids in America cover. I haven't seen Do Revenge, but like, I just know she was on it. And she sings One More Weekend, if you've heard that song. But I went to her concert and I went after class because I was in GA and I was so stressed that I was not like going to, you know, like I was like stressed because I had class until like 2:30 and I had to go home and get ready and like do all this stuff and like eat dinner, like make sure my makeup was done, like all this jazz. And I was like, crap, like there's gonna be all these people there. Like I'm not gonna get in, like I'm gonna be in the back, like yada yada yada. Like that's what I thought. Okay, like I was convinced that it was not gonna be good for me. Because I'm the type of person that's like at a concert, like we go, like we get up super early, go to the venue, camp out all day. But I was like, you know what, I need to be a good girl, I need to go to class, I need to be educated and not skip school because I also had a midterm, so like that was also important. I know we're having midterms like hella late, but we also started hella late, so. But I was like, I'm not gonna like skip class today. So I guess we'll just do All Around Sparkles. That's like the Glossier brand. It's like glossy. So I went and literally there's only one girl in front of me when I got there. I was so happy because I was like swag. Like I'm not gonna have to worry about that today. And I got Barricane and it was so freaking cool. Like Maud is just like one of the coolest people ever. And I think like one of her friends, like Simone, opened for her. And like that's like one of my new favorite artists. Like literally obsessed with her. Like got to talk to her after the show too. But yeah, like y'all heard it here first. Maud Latour, she's like the next big thing. She's like already like in the process of like kind of like slowly like built, like blowing up. But yeah, just saying, keep her on your radar, keep her, do not sleep on her. Anyway, but yeah, I'm really excited for what today will bring because I've never like been to like a grand opening before. And the totes, they're like, I don't know if they're selling them or giving them away. They better be giving them away because I love free things. Like, they're these, like, huge totes, like, just for Brooklyn. And I'm really hoping that they're not just, like, selling them. Because I hate when just, like, places, like, do stuff like that. And they're like, oh, like, exclusive. But, like, you have to pay, like, you know, $28 for it.
So, actually, oh my god, why does my voice sound like that? Hello? So, actually, the totes are not that big. I thought they were going to be these big ass totes, okay? Like, but they lied to us on TikTok. They lied. They're actually tiny. Let me get mine. Like, it looks big, like, but it's actually not that big. Like, this is not a big tote. But, I mean, it can... I forgot I left myself a Diet Coke in here. I'm actually so excited. But, I mean, it's a good, like, purse or something. Like, I use this when I just, like, need, like... phone, vlog camera, wallet, headphones, like, maybe a book. But yeah, it's a good, like, pursey thing. It doesn't, like, zip or close, but it has this cool pouch for makeup, which I keep stuff for touch-ups and all that jazz. And also, it was not for free. I got mine for free, but it was not for free. It was $38. But I mean, if I don't end up liking that, you might see it on my Depop. I don't know. We'll see. Here's a finished makeup look. I didn't do mascara on this eye. I'm an idiot. I'm a fucking idiot. That's a finished makeup look. I'm gonna straighten my hair and I'll see you guys in 2 seconds. Okay, my bangs are kind of crazy, but let's go. Okay, I just got to Williamsburg a little bit ago. I'm getting in the line right now. It's pretty long, but like not as bad as I thought. So that's fun. I'm super freaking excited. It's me lit. And there's an Urban Outfitters right by. So like it's gonna be a good day. I am happy that I got here early because the line is like kind of long to get in, but in like they opened like an hour 20, but I am glad I got here pretty early. That white building is it, but I'll let you guys know when we get in. Okay, line update. They gave us like these like free little mini donuts. Unfortunately, I ate them, so I cannot show you. But they gave us Glossier napkins. Like, I didn't even use it. Like, I'm literally gonna hang it up. Like, it's so fucking cute. And we also got like little like plant. I don't know. It smells cool. So excited. What time is it? I'm trying to get everything sorted away in my tote. It's currently 10:35, so we have like maybe like 25 minutes until the store opens. It's really cool. I like went down to like throw something away, but like they have a DJ and food trucks. The food trucks are right here, but it looks really fun and I'm really excited for everything to get going. Just got some hot chocolate too. I'm not a big hot chocolate person, but you know what? I will take anything for free. The opening of the store feels as if it is in sight, and I'm so freaking excited. Oh my god, I like cannot wait. 11 o'clock needs to get here quicker. Glossier Brooklyn is officially open for business, and we're about to go in, so I'll update you when we're inside. This was where we got our free donuts from, and they were so freaking good. Okay, but the life of a content creator is literally having your Instagram story ready to go and your vlog camera at the same time. Like, I'm like, high-key stressed, but like, we gotta get all the videos, we gotta get all the pictures. Like, this is embarrassing for me. I wanna like try to live in the moment too, because like that's what life is all about. Because the internet's gonna die, but still getting my content. Surprisingly, it's like actually like golden hour, like really hot, but I thought it was November, but I'm still vibing. Oh my god. This strap keeps falling down. I'm afraid I'm gonna pop a titty in the middle of Williamsburg. But that's okay.
Oh yeah, absolutely.
I'm officially the worst vlogger ever because I barely got any content actually from inside the store, but that's okay. Because you guys care more about like me waiting in line, I feel like. The store itself is like so fucking cute. Like I'm literally obsessed with it because like all Glossier stores are adorable and perfect and wonderful and gorgeous. This one, like the only thing I like complained about, like or would complain about, was really tiny. But like that's New York, and literally there were like a few like picture spots because I feel like a lot of like the main appeal of Glossier is like the photo stops, like spots. There were some, but like not a ton, but like who gives a fuck. Like there was good makeup, good quality stuff as always. I tried on a couple lipsticks and might have to go back and get some. It was just really chaotic and I didn't want to like do a whole ass like haul and like stock up on all my makeup that I need, because like I don't really need that much makeup right now, because I just like I just did my Glossier stock up recently. And but I mean, knowing me, I'm gonna go back. But I did get the exclusive bag for the Brooklyn location. I'm so excited. I don't know if I'm actually gonna use it, but I was also just thinking too that like if I don't use it that much in like a month or so, then I'll just sell on Depop for like more. But I do really, I think it's such a cute bag. And I also got a bomb.com, I got another lavender one. So excited for that, just because I love the lavender one. That's one of my favorites right now. I'm excited to try the bag out. I feel like it's gonna be good for like when I don't like I need more than like my keys and my wallet, like my wallet, my phone and keys and stuff, but like not enough to like fit a tote, like you know what I mean, like be a cute little purse. But anyway, I'm gonna explore Brooklyn. I'll take you along with me. Just went into Urban Outfitters. Didn't buy anything because I don't need anything right now. That'll change once I start Christmas shopping, but I'm just gonna walk around and enjoy my time in Williamsburg. I actually like Williamsburg a lot more than Dumbo. Don't tell me when I said that. but Williamsburg just feels like way more like chill and like, you know, East Village-y. And but I also do like visiting Dumbo. It's really cute, but yeah, let's just enjoy Williamsburg together.